Hello, I'm Dr. Deun Jeong, and today I'll be presenting the key findings from our paper titled The Global Burden of Vaccine-Associated Angioedema and Their Related Effects. To begin, I would like to briefly introduce VisiBase, the key database utilized in our study. VisiBase is the World Health Organization's global pharmacovigilance database managed by the Uppsala Monitoring Center. Since its inception in 1967, it has continuously collected individual case safety reports, offering a vast and diverse collection of data. Currently, more than 150 countries contribute to VisiBase, which now contains over 100 million individual case safety reports. For our study, we specifically extracted reports of angioedema that were attributable to vaccines from this extensive database. The figure on the left illustrates the geographical distribution of vaccine-associated angioedema reports divided into six territories. As you can see, the region of the Americas has the highest number of reports with 5,274 cases of vaccine-associated angioedema. The figure on the right shows temporal trend of these reports. Over the period from 1967 to 2023, we identified a total of 10,970 reports of vaccine-associated angioedema. Oh, this table is quite complex, so I will summarize the key point as concisely as possible. First, we classified vaccine into 16 categories. Then we analyzed the association between vaccines and angioedema using two disproportionality measures, the reporting loss ratio and the information components. To validate our primary finding, we conducted a sensitivity analysis that included only reports from healthcare professionals. As highlighted in the blue box, we considered the association between vaccines and angioedema significant only when both the main reports and those from healthcare professionals indicated significance. Since angioedema often co-occurs with urticaria, we also performed a disproportionality analysis to assess the association between vaccines and angioedema with urticaria. As shown in these blue boxes, 8 vaccines exhibited a significant association with angioedema accompanied by urticaria. The novelty of our finding lies in the observation that the same suspected substances, such as gelatin, egg protein, microbial components, polyethylene, and its derivatives, are present in multiple vaccines. However, the variation in the association between vaccines and angioedema, with or without urticaria, suggests that the underlying mechanism may not be IgE-mediated. Instead, it could involve non-IgE mechanisms such as complement activation, vaccine reactogenicity, or the host immune inflammatory response to vaccines. In conclusion, our study identified the association between vaccines and angioedema by utilizing the WHO pharmacovigilance database. Thank you for listening.